keep them going. Take wheels rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead, and the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever, 'cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man, and a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Some suicidal joker tried to run us right off the road. In the middle line, they're starting to do a hula.
You should have called me sooner. I don't want my rig danced off in a ditch.
Pull it over. I'll take it.
Okie dokie.
Bead, why don't you hit the sack?
I want to get some chow first.
Ah, no way. No stops till we hit Durham.
Well, Pruitt, you're a hard man, you know.
4:28, we should be in Durham before daylight.
Oh? You betting money, marbles, or chalk?
No slowdowns, no stalls, quote-unquote.
Hey, now, when did I ever hack a bet?
Well, there was that one time in Houston.
All right, now that doesn't count. I told you going in.
Okay.
That gal.
I don't want to hear about it. You still owe me $9, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, you want to bet or not?
Okay. $9 you owe me plus 11. 20 says we get to Durham by daylight.
$20 on what I pay you? Okay. It's going to be like taking candy from a baby.
Okie dokie. Just remember, king of the road. Got my eye on the speedometer.
Fire! Insurance covers everything but our time.
I wish that old man had stayed in the hospital like the doctors wanted him to.
You know, you'd have to put him in chains to keep him in there.
I'll be as quick as I can.
You take all the time you need.
And give my best to your daddy.
You tell him if there's anything we can do.
Thanks, fellas. I'll tell him. How's Daddy?
Fretful. And that's gonna turn to ornery when he sees you.
Hi, Dad. How you feeling?
What brought you out here? They got plague in the city?
Came as soon as I heard about the fire.
Well, then you done wasted your time. Fire's out. But going back to your friends with the shiny shoes.
Dad, I didn't come here to fight.
Well, what did you come for? The weep at McGrady?
Dad, please. Mr. Shelby said you were hurt.
Well, Shelby was right. I was hurt, but I ain't hurt no more. Now, leave me be. I got a crop to bring in.
Like that?
It ain't gonna come in by itself. Oh, it's for certain you change, Lee. The back never changes. The leaf's got the color. Caked it before it burns.
Got anybody to help you besides Mr. Shelby and that son of his?
No. They help when they can. But don't you fret yourself. I don't need you.
Well,
you're gonna need somebody regular. And if I'm all you've got, then you're just gonna have to put up with me.
Put up with you? Put up with you? Lord knows I've had plenty of practice doing that. The time you was nine trying to tell me what to do. Like trading one of my mules for a tractor.
And the first day we got that old used tractor,
she broke down and we had to hitch Henrietta to her.
And you made me get an umbrella, a green umbrella, and lead that mule. It was that hot. Tell you what, you get me a green umbrella and I'll pick more leaf than you can even.
I don't want you to put yourself out now.
Be back in a minute.
Oh, this is my brother, Lee. I'd like you to meet the guys who pulled Daddy out.
Yeah, so we... After we set his barn on fire.
Just one of those things.
Will Chandler. Johnny Pruitt.
Pleased to meet you, fellas. Fix a plate for me, Liz. I'll be back in a minute.
Like your baby brother's gonna be around for a while.
Looks that way. What'd you do? Nail his boots to the floor?
I don't think I get your drift, Lee. You mean you want to stay out here 4 or 5 days?
Yeah, to help him get his crop in.
If I don't, it's gonna burn up in the fields. He'll be wiped out.
I sure am sorry to hear that, Lee.
Oh, so am I. I mean, I'd like to help you out, but we got a shipment to get out.
You can spare me for a few days.
No, I can't. You the one that signs the Bill of Ladings and everything. Nobody even knows Jackson and I exist.
Cave's right, Lee. So you just trot back on up there and tell your daddy that you love him heaps, but you got more important things to do than be his field hand. I got a notion, Cave.
Yeah, what's that?
What do you see parked over there?
A truck, why?
What a truck's used for.
Hey, trucks are used for trucking.
breakfast, miss?
Liz.
Liz.
I tell you, those biscuits are great. My mama never made better.
Well, she could have. She knew how to open a can.
Oh, you're kidding.
Well, don't stay. I already told you I don't need you.
But, Daddy.
Don't daddy me, I told you. You ain't my son, not no more. Well, you go on back to that factory where you can wear a tie and a Judas smile. And tell them they ain't got nothing to worry about. They pet niggas still jumping on the end of the rope they got you on. Where's my breakfast? Man can't work on empty stomach.
Mr. Andrews, the doctor said you weren't supposed to work at all.
What am I supposed to do, whistle in my crop?
Your crop will have to wait.
Wait? You don't know nothing about tobacco.
I know you smoke and you shouldn't.
Yeah, you know, too, if it don't get took in at just the right time, it dries up to nothing.
No, I don't, but you're in no condition to work.
You listen to him, Otis Andrews.
When he says something worth hearing, I'll listen. Till then, I'd be obliged if y'all just shut up.
Better get going. I'm awful sorry your daddy tried to run into that barn.
His crop must mean a lot to him.
No more in his life.
Well, I understand that. I was a sharecropper's kid. Is your daddy working this place on shares?
No, it's his. He has 20 acres, his leaf, what was his new curing barn.
All his life he wanted thermostats. Finally got them and...
Well, for what it's worth, we'll bring those insurance forms over as soon as we can. Get it all straightened out. Thanks for breakfast. Will?
No, he means it. We're sorry.
Sorry will do.
Sure there's not something?
Don't worry about us. We'll make out fine.
Those two truckers owe you, after all.
They burned down your daddy's barn.
I'd rather not hear any more about it, Mr. Bleeding Heart.
I know you gave it the office, but it was our truck that started
my
the
truck.
Fire.
And my insurance will take care of it if I could ever figure out these forms.
Your rig, your insurance. See, that's what I mean. If we could just hang around for a couple of days. You know what I mean?
No, I don't know what you mean. All I know is I'm trying not to operate a non-profit business.
Mr. Pruitt?
What?
I'm Lee Andrews.
Oh, yeah, hi.
Oh, I was just on my way to the
insurance company to pick up those forms.
Well, we can save you the trip. We just got them. We were on the way out to your daddy's farm.
Yeah, well, I'll take care of it.
Thank you.
Look, if you're so interested in taking care of things for your daddy, why don't you go on out to the farm and help him do some work?
What, are you a social worker or a family counselor or something?
No, he's just a trucker who needs a load to get out of town.
Sorry. Say, I got a friend who needs a load taken to New York. You fellas interested?
Hey, we sure would be.
Okay. Pick up tonight. Move out first thing tomorrow.
Thank you.
See you around.
All righty.
I'll see you. You see...
No, come on, not again.
I don't like that guy.
What's not to like? You know what? We are on the beginning of a good streak. I can feel it. We can get this load to New York, get that rented trailer back to Durham within 24 hours. We're going to make some good money.
Sharecropper's kid, huh?
That's right. My daddy moved around a lot.
I bet you used to chop cotton. And,
oh, all right. Come on, it was Depression days. Rich kid.
I try explaining this load to me.
What's to explain? Paper goods to New York.
What kind of paper goods?
I don't know what kind of paper goods. Who cares what kind of paper goods?
Does that look like a paper goods warehouse where we picked up this load?
No, it looked like a distributing warehouse to me, a paper goods distributing warehouse.
Lee Andrews works per cigarette plant, doesn't he?
So
how come he is arranging night shipments of paper goods and paying top dollar for the load?
Maybe he moonlights for a paper goods company. I don't know.
You don't care either, do you?
You know what? I just said I was feeling good. You have a way of bringing a guy down off cloud nine quicker than anybody I ever met. called getting your feet back on the ground. Trucker of the month.
Start unloading.
All right.
Need any help?
Nah.
What are you doing?
Paper goods, huh?
That warehouse didn't belong to a licensed distributor.
Right.
Which means those cigarettes are going to go on the market without paying the New York tax.
Mm-hmm.
Crossed a few state lines, too.
Yep.
That's a federal rap.
Right.
Probably grand larceny, too.
I wouldn't doubt it a bit.
So why didn't you holler cop then and there and put those warehouse hustlers under lock and key?
I am not going to holler cop till we get back to Durham, and I can take Lee Andrews apart piece by piece, have him get us off the hook we're on, then I'll holler cop.
We'd like to talk to you for a minute.
Hi, fellas.
Hi.
You made good time.
Yeah, didn't we?
Everything turned out all right.
Oh, went fine. Right, Will?
Yeah. Easiest load of paper goods we ever had to deliver. Yeah, well, if I hear about another load, I'll let you know.
Yeah, you do that. In the meantime, do you want me to beat your brains out here, or would you prefer someplace else?
What's the problem, fellas?
I guess you want it here, huh?
Good here. Come into my office.
He's got an office.
Oh, well, that's better. That'll save the floor.
You want to tell me what all this is about?
No, we want you to tell us what this is all about.
See, Mr. Anderson, we're up against a 5-year prison rap. We'd like to know the whys and the wherefores.
Saw the cigarettes?
Yeah, and we saw your name on a bill of lading.
So we're going to the police.
And when my partner says we, he means him, me, and you.
Because we'd like you to tell him that we didn't know what we were carrying.
If this comes out, you know what it'll do to my father?
Oh, don't give me that bull about your father. If you cared so much about him, you'd be out there right now helping him bring his crop in.
Well, that's what I was going to do. But these guys who got me into this, they wouldn't let me.
They won't let you. Why don't you just sit down and tell me what this is all about? You know something? I believe him.
Yeah, so do I.
But what is hard to believe is how anybody could be that dumb.
What's that dumb?
Well, getting himself into something like that without knowing about it until it's too late.
We just got into something without knowing about it until it was too late.
Oh, yeah. I guess we did. I never thought of it that way.
Well, think about it, because what we're going to do now is going to get us in even deeper.
Your idea.
You didn't give me any arguments.
I never argue with my attorney.
You also never pay him his fee.
Just wanted to find out if your daddy had turned in those insurance forms yet.
The one time I asked daddy about signing them, he gave me 15 minutes on his hateful son and no answer. So if you're feeling brave today, you'll have to ask daddy about those papers.
Okay, where is he?
Out in fields with a mule sled picking. Broken leg, hailstones, locust, that's my daddy. Biblical.
What's the matter with you?
I hope these pigs end up tasting better than they smell.
Yeah, this will help you get over it.
Andrews, the doctor said you were supposed to rest.
The doctor ain't got no crop to bring in. I don't get my leaf in for curing this time, next 3 or 4 days. I might as well let it rot on the stem and turn it under.
Well, you can't do it all by yourself with no hands to help.
I got my own too, and Elizabeth. She's bigger way around any man. Every year, she comes all the way from Atlanta to help me. She's daughter and son. Mr. Pruitt, I don't let no man do no picking for me unless I can hire him. And I ain't got a smidgen of hiring money this year.
Advanced agriculture?
Where'd you find that?
Right over there in the garage. It was open.
It's Lee's from college. My dad blew his heart about Lee, but you notice he doesn't get rid of his stuff. I think he's working his way through all of them.
Learn about farming?
Maybe to learn about Lee.
You're the one I can't figure.
I'm no puzzle. 2 weeks out of the year, I pick tobacco.
What about the other 50?
Atlanta. 9 to 5 in a dress factory.
Sounds rough.
It's rough on the machine, but I graduated from that.
To what?
Answering dumb questions. And designing evening gowns.
Sorry.
No, I'm sorry. It's... Come next week, vacation time is over. And I'm gonna have to leave. And my daddy...
Is he gonna be able to get his crop in?
Without a heap of help, no way.
What's he doing out there killing himself?
It's his way. He knows he's gonna lose most of his crop, but he won't stand back and admit it.
I always expected Lee to be with me. I was content. Him going to college, book learning things about farming I never did know. I still don't know. Yeah. The first couple of summers he come home with ideas. Rotating crops, looping machines. Then some turned him around. That cigarette factory got him.
Here, Dad. Please stop working a little while.
Mr. Andrews, if you'll take it easy, we'll try to get you some help out here.
You mean just sit idle at a God-given crop burn in the sun?
No, I don't...
That's sinful. I've been farming this land all my life, from can't see to can't see. Leaf knows the feel of my hand. Yeah, gotta get it in fast. A hot spell is gonna sweat the leaf dry. Even my no-count son knows that.
Maybe you're being just a little too hard on him.
Then, no, you never mind.
Well, that's not exactly true. We kind of made it our business.
We leaned on him. He's coming out here.
I don't want him.
That's tough, because he's coming.
I won't have no truck with him.
Of course you won't, but at least you're going to hear him out.
First you burn down my barn, you start nosing into my family business. You didn't try to tell me what I will do and what I won't do.
What are you two up to?
We got a little plan.
What kind of a plan?
Help your daddy get his crop in and get Lee out of some trouble.
And get us 10 years in jail if anything goes wrong.
Coming?
Yep.
Tell him anything else.
We figured that was up to you.
Hi, Dad. I want to talk some.
Yeah, you was always good at talking. Just doing your shine.
I'll make it hard for me.
Yeah, man, he's got to do what he's got to do. Don't say no way, it's got to be made easy.
He's drying out fast.
Dad, I for what?
You're in my way. Now go on out of here. I don't need you.
But, Daddy, I need you.
What you saying? Now tell me straight out.
I okayed bills of lading without checking them out first. The cigarettes went to this warehouse where they were picked up and smuggled tax-free into New York. Before I realized what they were doing, it was too late. The only name written down was my name.
Our name. I'll say this much for you, son. That there college education me and your mama sweated to give you didn't teach you nothing about surviving.
No, sir.
Well, now what we got to figure out is how we gonna get you out of the muck you got yourself buried in.
Will and Sonny have an idea.
Yeah, I figured they would have. So why ain't they doing something about it?
We want your approval first. I told them that I wouldn't go along with anything without your say-so.
You did. Why'd you tell them that?
Well, you're my father, aren't you?
If I wasn't sweating and aching and hurting so much, I'd bust myself laughing. All right. Let's hear what them two is proposing.
Well.
Hi.
How you doing?
I understand you guys are looking for Lee Andrews.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, he's not here today. He called in sick.
Oh, well. Hold on a second. He gave us this load one way to New York and said if we wanted another to, come on back.
We all hold on. I'll give him a call at home. We'll see what we can come up with.
Appreciate it. Not you.
Yes, Cabe? Where is Lee? What's the matter with him?
I don't know. Flu or something. Look, Mr. Jackson, these two truckers are hot to try. And we've got a shipment going out tomorrow morning. Why not use them?
How are you going to get Lee's signature on a bill of lading?
Heck, man, I'll forge it.
Okay. I'll tell New York we're shipping them another load.
Might you. Yep.
Hey. You boys in luck. I just talked to Lee, and he says he's got a shipment going out tomorrow. Same time, same pickup.
Hey, that's great. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
All right, you're a fisherman. Now, in your experience, once you got them hooked, what are the chances of them wiggling free?
It depends on how deep you hook them.
Okay, how deep do you think we got ours hooked?
As deep as you can. Greedy. They're gonna have to forge Lee's name to that bill of lading or sign it themselves. Either way, we got them.
They are gonna be very upset when they find out what we're up to.
Telling me.
Well, we might as well scare up all the help we're gonna need.
For us and for Otis.
You ever kill two birds with one stone?
Oh, no, there's an original expression.
I just made it up. Hey, Marauder. Marauder, this is Sundance. Call him Marauder. Come in, Marauder. We know you're out there someplace.
Hey, Sonny Boy. What do you say? What are you doing?
Hey, guy. How would you like some soul food?
I like soul
food. Soul food.
What's that?
Thanks, Django. That's beautiful. You see any other indies or jockeys out there? You tell them to come on in. We need all the help we can get. Blue Eyes, too. This is Sundance calling. Come in. Come in, Blue Eyes, too. We know you're out there. Marauder told us.
Blue Eyes, too, is holding out on us.
Yeah, we'll find him. Hey, you pilots. There's some free chow on the East Hollow Road. All you got to do is get off your calluses and pick a little tobacco. Now, just picture this. Fresh air, fat back, and cornbread. Tanned yams.
Chitlins. Grits and gravy. And Carolina pork. The sweetest pork this side of heaven. I just made myself hungry.
Don't look at me. I never learned how to cook none of that stuff.
Liz, I promised them soul food.
Looks like this is the last slide we're going to get in today.
Tell me you're kidding, Liz. Tell me that you are the best soul food cook in North Carolina.
Well, if you want gourmet food, you're talking to the right lady. But Mama was the only soul cook around here that she didn't write nothing down.
Your Mama's the best cook I ever did know. She's as bad as a baby brother, Sonny. Neither of them ever did learn nothing worth knowing.
I'll tell you one thing I learned. These old flu-curing barns are inefficient. You rebuild the new ones with that insurance money, you want to make it for air curing, gas heaters. You could handle another 20 acres.
How come you know, but you don't do? If they learned you so much in college.
Space them, Will. Space them. The secret in good tobacco is in the cooking.
Man, this is killing me.
First halfway decent day's work you done since you left home. I wasn't knee high to a duck. I give up school in the fourth grade. Help me, Daddy.
9 years old, I was.
And walk 9 miles to the Mud Creek Baptist Church on Sundays and 4 miles to the neighbor's house to listen to the radio.
But what about that old mortgage story, Daddy? You know, the one about how you worked nights in the cannery and was in the fields by sunup?
Oh, don't tell that one, Daddy. It breaks my heart.
Stop talking that mess. Making light of the fourth commandment. What kind of way is that to treat a poor old man that worked all his days to leave a fortune behind? When the angel Gabriel blows that there trumpet, summon him to the last judgment.
If your daddy would tighten up his speeches, he might make a good actor.
You know something? He is a good actor.
You know something else? Somebody is going to have to cook enough soul food for about 20 hungry truckers before tomorrow morning.
Baking soda? No, it was baking powder.
Well, you better make that right, or I know some truckers are gonna bust the chef's head.
Hey, check the cornbread. I think it's done. That's enough collards.
What do you think?
Oh, yeah. Sit it down.
Oh.
Put a pat on it.
Boy, you're giving up pizza for life.
I hate to say it, but that beats my mother's cornbread 6 ways from Sunday.
What now?
I don't see any hot peppers or vinegar. I need vinegar for the chitlins.
Upright.
I always wanted to try chitlins.
They are without a doubt the best food in the world.
What are they?
Hog guts.
Sure do hope there's gonna be somebody to eat all that food. Here, give me a piece of chicken.
Watch it, it's hot. It
should be here any minute. I told them to get here early. Well, let's get to work.
Look at that bar. He's worrying about the clock like a sewn up bomber. Hey, there, here.
Let's see what we got.
Good to see you, Frank. How are
you?
Hey, Davey. No. Wait a minute.
Good direction.
No, you got to understand something. You got it all backwards. It's work first, then eat.
Oh.
The work is that way. Listen, say hello to Mr. Andrews on the way. That's the guy you're working
with. Hey, how about some down-home cooking,
all right, you're going to get it, man. Hey, guy, how you doing?
Hey,
Ryder,
let's
good
go.
Good to see you guys.
Okay.
This is the game, yeah.
Bottom to top. Hey, that's it. Hey, don't bruise those leaves now. Just lay them on there nice. Come on now. That's it. Hey. That's it. Bottom with top. Get that one, that nice one over there. Come on. Come on, Rody. That's it. You ain't working up enough of the sweat. You get an armful, put them on in the drag.
Oh,
your troubles cure? Will all your troubles cure? And the alcohol that it contains, will all your troubles cure?
Beside the hill there is a hill with smoke curls up to the sky. You can always tell the whistling bell that the liquor boys are nigh. That the liquor
yes,
boys
saying it ain't working, but you're sure some pretty fair pickers for truckers.
Looks like you know what you're doing.
Why not? I was born to it.
You're on your own. Crew and I are taking off.
Sure you don't want me to come along?
Be funny, wouldn't it? You're supposed to be in bed with the flu.
Right. Yeah, but Will, take care. Anything goes wrong, you'll have a lot more to deal with than Cabe and Jackson. They got a lot of heavy muscle that they can use if they need to.
Well, they're gonna need to.
Time to get moving.
You know, it's breaking my heart to have to leave here when my food's hitting the table.
It's not breaking your heart, it's breaking your stomach. Let's go.
Liz?
There'll be plenty left when you get there.
Promise?
Come on, greedy guts. You can put the pot on later. Let's go.
Better meet it all up.
Y'all take care now.
It's the chitlins I want.
Don't worry, I'll save you some.
Sure use a lot of paper goods in New York City.
Must be a lot of money in paper goods.
About $100,000 a load when you do it this way.
$100,000?
Well, here's your bill, lady. And your money, like you asked for it. $800, right? Yeah, okay. Well, I tell you, it's a pleasure doing business with you. See you again. That in the bank.
It's for the $800.
That's our trucking fee to New York, same as last time.
Not going to New York.
Oh, I know that, and you know that, but they don't know that.
You're getting to wonder who the thieves are
now,
around
don't
here.
Don't start that. We got to pay the rental and the trailer, right? And then there's the chitlins and the cornbread and the grits and all that stuff.
Yeah. Soul food comes high.
It's inflation, man. It's hitting everybody.
Well, those turkeys are on their way.
Good. I'll call New York.
See that bill of lading? Forge Lee's name. See that?
Uh-huh. And we know he was nowhere near the place.
He's probably got 20 people that can swear to that.
What's the penalty for forgery in this state?
Well, I don't know. A couple of years.
Well, would that run at the same time as the 5 years they're going to get for violating the tax laws, or do they tack it on at the end?
Oh, that depends on New York State. Probably concurrently.
That means at the same time, right? Am I right? What time you got?
What time have you got?
I got almost 5.
You're right.
I thought so. My stomach is grumbling.
Well, that's a change. It's usually your mouth.
No. My mouth is watering. I'm thinking about all that fabulous, expensive soul food that I was up all night cooking.
Who was up all night cooking?
All right. Sure, you helped, but I was the chef. I tell you, I can hardly wait to taste the fruits of our labors.
Cabe? Those two truckers, they just hijacked your load.
What?
Now, how do you know? You're supposed to be home in bed sick.
I am, but they just called and told me. They want me to negotiate a price for the return of the load.
Those two truckers that hijacked our load.
Give me that
phone. Lee, what's going on here?
Yeah, Ralph, that's what they told me. I'm as shook up as you are. You gotta promise me if I tell you, you'll just go over and talk with them. You won't start no trouble. Okay. They got the truck over at my father's farm. Yeah, Ralph, I figured that's what you'd say.
Good luck. He's on his way.
To negotiate.
Sure. The best way he knows how.
Well, it just gives me time to eat. Let's get out the soul food, lady.
Go take a little walk.
Wait for me, hero.
You make it a trio. I'll join you.
What good will you be? The guy's got the flu.
Well, I made a miraculous recovery.
Sure don't like sitting around the house. I'll take me a look in the barn. See how my curing's coming.
Now, Daddy.
Don't daddy me, daughter. I never thought it'd happen. Got my crop picked. All of it. Picked by the courtesy of them two fellas. And it'd be downright ungrateful of me if I didn't check up on it from time to time.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Drive that rig back to the warehouse.
Oh, you want to make a deal then, huh?
That's right, friend. We're going to make a deal.
See, I told you they'd make a deal.
Well, sure. That's because of our negotiator.
That's right. Thanks, negotiator.
Hey, man. You're dead.
Hey, does he know how to drive that rig?
He knows.
Okay. What's the deal?
First, we had in mind to take our goods back to the warehouse. Then we had in mind teaching you that it don't pay to mess in things that are way out of your league.
How are you going to do that? We're going to fix it so the only thing you driving for the next couple of years is a wheelchair.
Now, you understand, lawyer, that they are threatening us with bodily harm.
Yeah, I understand.
Those two guys are going to take on the three of us.
Four of us!
Oh, I'm sorry, Otis. I didn't mean to leave you out. The four of us. Well, that hardly seems fair. Makes the odds a little better.
Better for them, but not better for us.
Get him! All right. You've won this round, but you've got nothing.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that, would you, partner?
Well, we got a bill of lading with a forged signature.
For a shipment of bootleg cigarettes to an illegal warehouse in New York?
It's not going to do you any good. We've got the shipment. Not strictly accurate.
Well, you see, I just happened to call the state police and tell them to look out for my rig. I reported it stolen.
Sounds like they found it.
Real sharp shirt you got there.
Oh, thank you.
Why don't you buy one?
I can't afford it.
You know, you might also get a little hair trim while you're at it.
I don't have the time.
Look, we're coming into Durham. We're running ahead of time. You can get it here, okay?
Okay. Hey, when was Lee Andrews' hearing?
16th.
That was yesterday.
Yeah. I wonder what he got.
Let's stop and find out, all right?
There goes the haircut.
What can you do, Bob?
How'd
the hearing go?
Well, Jackson and Cave got 5 years apiece.
That's all right. How did you do?
6 months probation. Man, am I ever mad.
What have you got to be mad about?
My probation officer? He's a tobacco farmer. So he knows my daddy. They've been buddies for years.
Still doesn't explain why you should be mad.
Well, one of the conditions of my probation is that I work the 6 months on my daddy's farm.
Son, Leah's turned up the figures and we're doing pretty good.
We're supposed to do good. We got the best leaf in Durham County.
go on back in there and see the business.
Yes, sir, Mr. Andrews, sir. You know something? I might get to like this.
We'll see. Mr. Andrews, we got a roll.
Yeah, nice meeting y'all, boys. Come back again and fix some back.
Well, not exactly the same way we did this time.
We'll see you. See you.
Pretty good fellas there.
192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192, 192